दिल्ली स्थित NASC कॉम्प्लेक्स पूसा के AP शिंदे हॉल में इंडियन चैम्बर ऑफ फूड एंड एग्रीकल्चर और एग्रो वर्ल्ड 2019 का आयोजन किया गया, जिसमें नेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस ऑन डबलिंग एग्री एक्सपोर्ट और वर्ल्ड एग टेक कांग्रेस का आयोजन किया गया। कार्यक्रम में बतौर मुख्य अतिथि नीति आयोग के उपाध्यक्ष डॉक्टर राजीव कुमार व केंद्रीय कृषि आयोग डॉक्टर SK मल्होत्रा मौजूद थे। इसमें कृषि जगत से जुड़ी तमाम दिग्गज कंपनियां व हस्तियों ने हिस्सा लिया। कृषि जगत से जुड़ी तमाम हस्तियों को अवार्ड देकर सम्मानित किया। आप भी देखिए ये रिपोर्ट।
Government to government project that is between the Ministry of Agriculture. in Moshav, the development agency that I'm representing, and we are working across India. In this map, you can see the dots of centers of excellence that we have established. Currently, we have 28 centers of excellence, and these centers of excellence, and this picture is one of them, is an advanced intensive agriculture farm. And this is a point in where we try to leverage the solution tailored to the local conditions and make, at the end of the day, the farmer a stronger competitor in the market he's working at. We are looking at the solution on a value chain perspective. So we are focusing on cultivation, on harvest, post-harvest marketing. But this guy holding the oranges box, this is Kino. When he's standing with a premium quality product, then we are winning. Then we achieve the goal we are aiming to do. We also have in our activity, we are leveraging precision agriculture. I started with it because this is a theme of the talk today. So we are having a weekly satellite image of every center of excellence in India. And this image is giving us the climate conditions, and for this we take the precise irrigation, because we are leaning the irrigation based on climate and phenological stage. So the picture on the low right side is the satellite image that you received, and this is the actual image on a week basis from Bagalkot, Karnataka, but we have it in 28 locations. And now this is the first season, now we are starting to collect the data, and I am sure that in the next couple of weeks and months, I can share with you the outcome of what is the value of this tool. We are focusing on horticulture, and this is what I will talk. These are the key crops that we are having. And we are introducing Israeli varieties, but not only, also leaning on Indian local varieties. We are tailoring solutions, so every greenhouse, every orchard that we are putting will always have a pre-planning phase in which we say, is this a justified investment? We're doing everything on a large scale, so we're not in the field of university and research. We are more towards applicable demonstrations. So this is a citrus farm in Nagpur. We are having a nursery management in each center that creates sustainability and produces millions of seedlings every year. And drip irrigation is a major focus, so every center is having the Israeli technology, but again, we tailor it to the local condition in terms of climate and ground demand. We use the drip irrigation to leverage the fertilizers, and we have canopy management, so we actually show how to do intensive agriculture, and the outcome of how to do it is canopy management that should be different. We do plant protection, and all of this, again, comes into a form of a value chain. Knowledge transfer is something we are really insisting on. So we are training Indian officers, and these officers are training Indian farmers. Last year alone, 2018, we trained 140,000 farmers, 1.4 lakh farmers across India. And the next step, and this is the last slide about what we are doing, is that we want the Center of Excellence to grow into 50 villages. So we are having this plan in the pipeline now, and this is what we want to do. In short, precision agriculture. Precision agriculture can be broken down into a few boxes. Irrigation management, sensors, and decision support systems are there. For example, tensiometers, which we are using on a conventional level, putting these tensiometers in the ground, close to the ground, will tell us how much water we have in different depths. And this graph shows you the 30, 60, and 90 centimeters, or in this case, it's a 15, 30, 45 centimeters depth because it's vegetables. And we can see the root system activity, and we can see when we are over-irrigating. This will enable us to increase the water use efficiency, and it will also enable us to know when and how much to irrigate. In Israel, we have these weather stations that for me are precision agriculture. They give us the climatic data, and the farmer can see this data, and as I showed you today, we are using satellite to get this data, and this, together with the plant stage, we know how much to irrigate every day. Precision agriculture can be these drones that we are flying. this is being done. In this case, it's a tailored machine made in Israel to harvest better. Spraying can be differentiated between the field according to the canopy and DVI, the different structure of the leaves and so on. So these robotics are happening, but we should always justify them. Not every solution is a good solution. Field machinery. This picture is a machine of a drip line being embedded under the ground. We call it soil, under the soil, subsurface drip irrigation. Now, when we have this, the tractor today can know exactly the layout of the pipes in the field. So when he's embedding the drip line, he can know now you are moving under a big manifold that is moving water, not a drip line. So he knows how to pick the machine, go through, and take it down. All automatic, based on precision agriculture. Post-harvest. Post-harvest, again, this is a final stage of the value chain, but it is, in my opinion, one of the most important. And here we're talking about how to do the grading, the packaging, and the transport.